subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 25th of October. PM Modi launches Pan-India Health Infrastructure Scheme for world-class facilities. US was losing war to Taliban in Afghanistan, so it negotiated, says former envoy Zalmay Khalilzad. And Pakistan government will fulfill commitments made with banned group TLP, says Interior Minister Rashid. And now for all the details, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday launched Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission, touted as country's largest pan-India scheme to scale up health infrastructure in his parliamentary constituency Varanasi in poll-bound northern Uttar Pradesh state. The objective of the scheme is to fill critical gaps in public health infrastructure, especially in critical care facilities and primary care in both urban and rural areas.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission, one of the largest pan-India schemes for strengthening healthcare infrastructure and release of operational guidelines in his parliamentary constituency Varanasi in poll-bound northern Uttar Pradesh on Monday. It is in addition to the National Health Mission. Its objective is to fill gaps in public health infrastructure, especially in critical care facilities and primary care in both urban and rural areas. It will provide support for 17,788 rural health and wellness centers in 10 high-focus states. Further, 11,024 urban health and wellness centers will be established in all the states. Addressing the event, Modi took the opportunity to congratulate India for achieving the milestone of administering 1 billion vaccine doses in the fight against the coronavirus.
Corona mahamari se apni ladai mein 100 करोड़ वैक्सीन डोज के बड़े पड़ाव को पूरा किया है। बाबा विश्वनाथ के आशीर्वाद से, मां गंगा के अविरल प्रताप से, काशी वासियों के अखंड विश्वास से, सबको वैक्सीन मुफ्त वैक्सीन का अभियान सफलता से आगे बढ़ रहा है।
Under the scheme, a National Institution for Health, four new National Institutes for Virology, a regional research platform for WHO Southeast Asia region, 9 biosafety level 3 laboratories, 5 new regional national center for disease control will also be set up. The Prime Minister also inaugurated various development projects worth more than $702.6 million for his constituency. Earlier, he also inaugurated 9 medical colleges from Siddharthnagar district.
India's Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla on Monday said that BIMSTEC, the Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multi-Sectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation, is a powerful engine of economic growth with 21.7% of the world population and a combined GDP of US $3.8 trillion. Speaking at the inaugural address at BIMSTEC Symposium, Shringla said that the regional organization has added significance for the development of India's northeastern region. Terming neighborhood first and act East policy relevant for BIMSTEC, Shringla said that BIMSTEC is unarguably a crucial link in connecting South and Southeast Asia. BIMSTEC is a regional organization comprising 7 member states around the Bay of Bengal region. 5 members from South Asia are Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, India and Sri Lanka, and 2 from Southeast Asia are Myanmar and Thailand.
Neighborhood First and Act East, both of which are relevant for BIMSTEC, are the cornerstone of India's foreign policy. BIMSTEC is unarguably a crucial link in connecting South and Southeast Asia.
Pakistan has temporarily closed the key border crossing Chaman with Afghanistan, apparently due to the fear of the influx of refugees eager to leave their homeland after the Taliban took control in August. On Sunday night, hundreds of people stranded on Chaman border were seen hastily walking towards the border crossing as it opened briefly for about 3 hours. Afghans stranded on the Pakistani side of the border also threw stones at border security, demanding that the crossing be reopened on Sunday morning.
The Chaman border crossing between Pakistan and Afghanistan is the second largest commercial border point after the Torkham commercial town in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa that links with the Spin Boldak in the Afghan province of Kandahar. Hundreds of people stranded on Chaman border were seen hastily walking towards the border crossing as it opened briefly for about 3 hours around 9:30 p.m. Pakistan time, that is 16:30 GMT on Sunday. Those stranded on either side of the border for some days, some for even months, were seen arriving back to their respective countries. Earlier in the day, hundreds of Afghans stranded on the Pakistani side of the border threw stones at border security, demanding that crossing be reopened. The border has been closed for nearly 3 weeks now. The law enforcement authorities used tear gas to disperse the crowd. The Chaman border crossing is used by thousands of laborers as well as traders from both countries on a regular basis. Pakistani officials have said the border has been temporarily closed due to concerns of an influx of Afghans who are trying to leave their homeland after the Taliban seized power in August. The Chaman Spin Boldak crossing generates huge revenue for Pakistan and Afghanistan. Nearly 1,000 trucks carrying commercial goods cross the border each day during times of peace.
Moving on, the United States was losing the war to the Taliban, so it chose negotiations as an alternative. Former U.S. envoy to Afghanistan Zalmay Khalilzad told CBS in an interview broadcast on Sunday. Speaking for the first time since his resignation on October 18th, Khalilzad expressed reservations about the U.S. decision to lift conditions on the withdrawal deal he had negotiated with the Taliban during the administration of the President Donald Trump.
Zalmay Khalilzad, former United States Special Representative for Afghanistan Reconciliation, in an interview with CBS News on Sunday said that despite multiple efforts by the U.S. to strengthen its position on the battleground with the Taliban, it was unsuccessful. Speaking for the first time since his resignation was announced on October 18, Khalilzad strongly defended the Doha deal that he had negotiated with the Taliban during the administration of President Donald Trump to withdraw U.S. troops from America's longest war. The former envoy indirectly called out U.S. President Joe Biden for a calendar-based approach rather than the planned conditions-based extraction of troops from the war-torn nation. Khalilzad also blamed then-President Ashraf Ghani for the disintegration of Afghanistan's security sector, saying his escape triggered the chaos in the Afghan capital. Ghani fled Kabul as government authority crumpled and the Taliban marched into the capital city on August 15. Khalilzad said that he decided to resign at a time when Washington is beginning a new phase of policy toward Kabul following the withdrawal from Afghanistan in August. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken last week announced that Khalilzad will be replaced by his deputy, Tom West.
And in news from Pakistan, locals across Pakistan have expressed dismay and anger over what they term as a tsunami of inflation. They have blamed they were already struggling with the economic fallout from the COVID-19 pandemic, but the frequent price rise of food, fuel and other essential commodities has made their survival difficult.
Locals in Pakistan's financial capital of Karachi have said that a tsunami of inflation has hit them hard and the frequent rise in prices of food and other commodities has made their life extremely difficult. They have expressed dismay and anger against Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government for substantial hike in fuel prices this month, which they believe will once again lead to increase in prices of edibles as they are transported via road. They said the economic crisis has shattered their faith in the Prime Minister, who had promised to reduce poverty and provide jobs.
Sir, mehngai ka tufaan aane wala nahi, mehngai ka tufaan aa chuka hai. Theek hai na? Imran Khan sahab ka bus chale na, to petrol bhi 127 rupaye, wo 200 rupaye liter bhi le jayenge. Aaiye, aaj jo aap dekh rahe hain mehngai ko, ki hum log tel ka dabbe lete the 1100 rupaye ke, 1200 rupaye, wo aaj khade mein 1800-1900 rupaye pe. Aaiye, gareeb aadmi ka guzara to mushkil ho gaya hai.
Ab hamara kaam chota sa hai. 250-300 rupaye kamate hain aur ghar ka kharcha kitna sara कैसे पूरा होगा बल्कि दूध भी सुना है कि 150 रुपए किलो होने वाला है 130 तो है ही
Meanwhile, the multi-party opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement has also launched 15-day nationwide demonstrations against the unprecedented inflation, slamming PM Imran Khan over his government's policies and failure to control the continuous price rise. The ruling PTI government's ministers have, however, pinned the rise in inflation as a global phenomenon.
Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid Ahmed has vowed to fulfill the commitments the government made with the banned Islamist group Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan during negotiations a day earlier. Addressing a press conference on Monday, Rashid said that the matter would be discussed during a cabinet meeting on Wednesday following Prime Minister Imran Khan's return from Saudi Arabia.
Pakistan Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid Ahmed in the press conference on Monday assured to accomplish the commitments made with banned Islamist group TLP Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan a day earlier while terming its chief Saad Hussein Rizvi to be very cooperative compared to the other leaders of the proscribed organization. Rashid said the matter would be discussed during the cabinet meeting on Wednesday following Prime Minister Imran Khan's return from Saudi Arabia. Regarding Rizvi's release, the interior minister said there were legal lacuna that the TLP chief understands. This comes as the government on Sunday released more than 350 activists of the TLP, besides announcing that the cases against others would be withdrawn by Wednesday in what appeared to be another total surrender before the violent protesters marched towards the capital. Hundreds of TLP workers since Friday took to the streets throughout the country to exert pressure on the government for the release of Rizvi. Rizvi has been held in custody since April 12 when he led protests calling for the expulsion of the French ambassador to Pakistan over comments by French President Emmanuel Macron last October that were interpreted by many as Islamophobic. So far, several people, including policemen and TLP workers, have been killed in the past 3 days when fierce clashes erupted between the protesters and police in Lahore.
An artist in India's western Rajkot city came together to create colourful murals of Indian celebrities and gods and goddesses, while some pay tribute to the COVID-19 frontline warriors over the weekend. Colourful mural is an important part of every festival in India and can often be found inside temples, homes and even in exhibitions.
As many as 77 artists came together to create 125 colourful rangolis or murals of Indian celebrities and gods and goddesses over the weekend in western Rajkot city of Gujarat. The murals showcase Bollywood megastar Amitabh Bachchan, Olympic gold medalist Neeraj Chopra, historical figures, Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore and Indian soldiers among others.
In 77 logon ne participate kiya hai, chhatron ne. और 125 रंगोलीस इसमें बनाई है अलग अलग थीम पे काम कर रहे हैं कई लोग गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट नीरज चोपड़ा की बना रहे हैं तो कई लोग हैं वो अमिताभ बच्चन की बना रहे हैं तो कई लोग हैं जो भारत के नौजवान सैनिकों हैं उसके बारे में बना रहे हैं रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर की है
तो जब नीरज चोपड़ा ने हमारे देश के लिए गोल्ड मेडल जीता तब से मुझे लगता था कि मैं कुछ उनके लिए करूँ क्योंकि वो देश के लिए एक प्रेरणा बन चुके थे तो अब मुझे करना यही था कि मुझे मेरे लिए उनको कुछ चित्र बनाना था और मैंने ये चित्र रंगोली के कलर से बनाया है
Some artists also created regular natural scenery and portraits of Hindu gods and goddesses, while some paid tribute to the COVID-19 frontline workers. People traditionally make murals for several days around Diwali festivities with powdered colors. Most of the murals reflect traditional roots, but evolving art has brought contemporary touch to the customs.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.